This podcast is a member of the Place to Be Nation family. Visit us at placetobenation.com, the only place to be in your pop culture world.
Place to Be Nation, welcome to Geek and Sassy. My name is Jennifer Smith. I'm here with the wonderful and beautiful and amazing and talented and brilliant Miranda. Hey, Miranda.
Hey, that's a lot of, like, really fantastic adjectives there.
Well, I feel like you need some, so I'm going to give you some.
Oh, thank you. Wait, I would take those right now.
How did we get dirty so quickly? I didn't even intend for that to happen.
I don't know. Because I was going to say, I was just thankful itching wasn't one of those adjectives.
Well, I'll add that next time. But...
Okay, I'm open. No.
And, you know, of course, we have to do the obligatory, it's been forever since we recorded, conversation that we always have.
And disclaimer, it's probably going to... There may be some more hiatuses forever. Well, not forevers. No, not forevers. Dear God, what was the word you just used? They're like, yeah, in forever. Thank you. Jeez, I can't think.
We there's been things happening, and there things will continue to happen. And Geek and Sassy might be a little bit of a wild card when it comes to scheduling shows. But nevertheless, when we can, we will.
And that's what makes us great.
Is what makes us great. Yeah. Among other things.
Yeah.
Something else that's great is what we're going to do tonight. It is the second annual Sassy Awards.
I'm in the...
So we solicited ballots from you guys, our amazing listeners, and a good handful of you turned some in, so I was proud of that. And we have some awards to give away.
And if you didn't turn one in, but you kept telling me you were going to turn one in, I want you to go listen to the For Shame Bell, mm-hmm. like 50 gazillion times, okay?
You know who you are.
I won't call out any names.
I'm just saying, he knows. And...
Oh, he knows.
And so, you know, along the way, I think that we can maybe... You know, give our thoughts about the winners and the losers here, and perhaps discuss some of the other ballot choices that were submitted.
Yeah.
All right. What do you want to do first here?
I don't know. There's, like, so many options. Well, we did tone it down, so...
Yes, we did.
There are 22 categories this
22.
Year?
22. Pared down from last year's
47. I was just really excited. Okay, people? Super excited.
Yeah.
Even Jenny was like, are you sure this is not too many? I'm like, no.
All of the categories. I think that was a 4-hour show, but that's okay.
So
if you don't get us as often, at least you get us for twice as long.
There you go.
Just as it should be. All right. First up, we have the Sassy Award for Best or Favorite Streaming Service. And the winner is Netflix, of course. This is pretty much a given, although... There's a plethora of streaming services.
There were Hulu was a close
was
second.
It
was. Mm. It was actually.
Hulu does have some quality shit right now.
It does. Oh, and in fairness, I forgot to disclaimer this before we started here. So we made a few other changes this year as well, other than condensing the awards, is that last year Jenny and I both submitted ballots as well. Mm-hmm. And this year, Jenny and I did not. I tabulated them, and Jenny, if needed, was a tiebreaker. Which, she was needed twice.
Okay, fair.
So, to make it fair, like, across the playing field. So there's no, like, you know, the things that get said about other award shows where the fairness was not used. No, no. Totally fairly tabulated to the point where Miranda was even like, are you for real? Okay, that's the winner.
did we not have a favorite podcast Sassy Award? I mean, or is that just a given?
I thought we did, but then I was like, you know what? I think that that's a given that me and Jenny are going to say Geek and Sassy. So.
And also everybody else would say that.
And everybody else would say
it would be unanimous.
Right. Like, you don't write into an award show to hosted by a podcast and tell them that another podcast is the favorite.
Right, right. You're right.
So, it's a given that the second annual Sassy for the Best podcast goes to... Oh my god, it's Geek and Sassy! That was not on the ballot, but that's totally happening.
Alright. So, did you vote for Netflix? Oh, shit, we didn't vote. Goddamn.
I didn't vote, but Netflix would have won.
Okay.
Yeah, like, it would have been my answer had I put in one, to be honest with you.
Same. Alright, what do we got next?
So, next we have favorite TV sidekick. I love this little category, because there's so many options.
Mm-hmm.
I was excited for this. Our winner is none other than the Cisco Ramon.
Ooh, from Flash.
Flash, a.k.a. Vibe.
That Cisco is a good choice. I think my choice would have been from The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, her manager, and her name is... I'm blanking. But anyway, I think she's a great sidekick.
You know, I have yet... With all good intention, I yet still to watch that.
Oh, it's great. You really should. Everybody should watch that show.
So behind on so much stuff. It's
okay. Her name is Susie, by the way, on that show.
Like her character?
Yeah, her character's name is Susie.
Gotcha.
All right. Next up we have favorite app. And the winner, I think in a kind of surprise win, is Twitter.
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
I wouldn't have listed Twitter.
Probably
honestly.
Not.
But I don't think mine, just because I know the other answers, and now I'm like looking around for my laptop. I knew the other answers, so mine still wouldn't have won, but mine, if I had submitted, would have been Instagram.
Oh,
I just get lost for hours on Instagram. And there's no BS on Instagram. There's no, like... You know, in Facebook land, which I love Facebook, you have to dig through, like... everybody's personal opinions on, like, politics and shows and just, like, everything like that. And on Instagram, you just kind of see, like, the best of everybody's life, if that makes sense.
It does, yeah. I think that's deliberate.
Right, it's good, but I mean, I find comfort in Instagram.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
So, and we got some of our nominations there, because that one was a different one. We got... Duolingo and
a Tinder.
You did get, yep, and DC Universe app.
Oh, that's good. That's a good one.
Yahoo Sports. So, I mean, we got some, then that's when our Twitter and our Twitter and our Twitter start happening. But we did get some, we got Facebook Messenger, which is separate from Facebook. We got actual Facebook Messenger.
That would probably be my answer.
See. Huh?
That would probably be mine, too.
I mean, I could totally see that. I could totally see that.
I'm on it all day, so, I mean, I guess that would win.
A Hoopla? That one made me happy.
That's good.
That's a good one. And then podcast, and then we got one that was a general, like, any podcasting app, because this person really loves podcasts. And you and I can both take a guess at who that is.
Yeah.
Right. We love her so much.
Yes, we do. All right, what's next?
So, favorite song winner, which this one kind of came as no surprise, especially after doing the award show that I did with the other lovely members of Place to Be Nation. The winner for our Sassies is Shallow by Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper from A Star is Born.
Nice. That's good. That's a good pick.
It is a good song. Mm-hmm. And very much is.
All right, and the next award goes to a favorite book. And not surprisingly, we had a comic book. It is Doomsday Clock by Jeff Johns.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
I was just going to say, it made me wonder when I was tabulating these answers, if maybe I shouldn't have, because I'm not at all angry that favorite book is a comic book, and a very great one, mm-hmm. I might add. But I was wondering, I was like, you know, I know I was trying to lessen the amount of categories, but I'm wondering if maybe I should have had one for favorite book and then favorite comic book, just because we are, we're on the pop feed and we talk about more than comic books, but we are comic related. Mm-hmm. So I was like, so idea for the third annual, may spit out a book and a comic book category.
That's
there.
A good idea. I would get behind that. What's next?
So the next one is one where I had to have Jenny take care of a tiebreaker situation. Mm-hmm. And I was like, hey, and I'm sure she knew why I was asking her, but I randomly texted her and I was like, if you had to pick one of these, please pick. And she's like, okay. But we did favorite reality TV show. And I will say, not everyone that sent in a ballot had a favorite. And mm-hmm. totally understand that. I added this category because I know we have a lot of listeners that do watch reality television. I don't particularly, there's a couple of shows that I've mentioned before that I watch, but I'm not a huge reality TV person.
Same, yeah. It was...
There were some, the people that did give me some options gave some decent options. So our winner for this year is going to go to Survivor, who is still on after I don't know how many seasons at this point.
See, that's why I picked it as a tiebreaker, because I figure it's got to be pretty good if it's been on for this long.
I do remember watching it when it first came out.
Yeah.
And then there were a couple of seasons in college that I was really invested in it for some reason, and I don't remember why.
Sometimes it just catches you and you just get sucked in,
I guess.
Yep. All right, and so that goes to our next category, which is favorite TV show. And I was surprised by this win as well. Arrow on the CW gets the Sassy Award.
And kind of glad that Arrow was our winner. And trust me, it was very much the winner. That was almost a, hey, Jenny, can you tie break this one too? But it got one more vote when I kept scrolling through everybody's stuff. Because in sad news, next season, which will be season number, help me, Jenny.
Eight,
okay. Is a partial season. So it's going to be a 10 episode run and will be its final season. So
yeah, I was really sad about this and in denial about it when they first announced it. But then watching this season and wondering what else they could do,
mm-hmm.
and knowing that the actors are probably pretty done with it by this point, I guess it's probably the best decision they could have made.
Well, and it came within the same week as my beloved Supernatural informing us that they too will, next year will be season 15, but, or will it be 16? Anyway, we're 15 seasons. They are doing a full 2022 episode run, which is the normal season.
Yeah.
It is. They're closing it out. I hope Arrow does the same thing, but they're closing it out. But I have speculations as to why both of these shows are ending now.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you've noticed, the spinoff of The Vampire Diaries is going well.
Mm-hmm.
And Riverdale is still going well, mm-hmm. to some people's shock. I'm actually haven't watched the season at all, so I know.
I was going to say, I'm behind. Really out of the Riverdale loop.
Yeah, and I was, like, all up in that Riverdale loop and, like, tooting its horn, but I'm so behind, like, I can't say yay or nay for this season, to be honest with you. And then they did a new run of Charmed. It's like the other one never happened, essentially. It's not a spinoff, it's a reboot.
Right.
And then it was announced a couple of weeks ago that there would be a reboot of Buffy.
Mm-hmm.
So it's making me... Oh, and then Roswell. They redid Roswell.
Mm-hmm.
So, making me wonder if the CW is doing its revamp, like it did a few years ago, that brought all of us back to the CW. We started, you know, when we started with Arrow, actually. And, you know, Supernatural was running at that time, had been for several seasons, then we got Arrow and then Flash. Makes me wonder if they're starting a turning of the times, essentially, that happens every so many years with CW and bringing in, like, a different...
You mean getting away from the comic book shows?
Not just the comic book shows, but in general, like, kind of starting a new, you know, rolling in a new... They're getting a younger... Not... Okay, we're old. Basically, right. They're bringing in a new, like, the crowd that follows Riverdale and the new Charmed and the Legends... I mean, the spinoff to Vampire Diaries... They're starting to, if you've noticed, every so many years they start bringing in a different group to the CW. Makes me wonder if they're kind of doing that again, kind of revamping, returning. Because they tend to do that every so many years.
My hope for this was that the new Batwoman show would take the place of the sort of grittier, you know,
vigilante type
show. You know, just sort of step into Arrow's place with the new Batwoman. So, I don't think it's been ordered to season yet, just the pilot. So, I guess we'll see about that.
Well, are you sure it hadn't been ordered just to season, first season?
Last I knew, it was just the pilot.
Well, then that scares me, because in CW fashion, there have been plenty of times where they've ordered a pilot.
And then completely knocked
it down, yeah. Like, just weeks before it was supposed to.
I don't know. If the Batwoman pilot could be as strong as her debut on the crossover, the Elseworlds crossover, then I don't see any reason why they wouldn't continue to.
No, I'm with you.
That.
Like, I'm here for it. Yeah, like, I totally need that to happen.
So, anyway.
Just going along with that there.
I am glad that Arrow won, though.
Yeah, definitely. And I don't remember. I guess you read that one, didn't you? So, favorite animated TV show only shocked me just a little. And the reason I say that is because I haven't watched this show. And I explained to Jenny why I haven't. And she got it. But I don't know if I have ever explained it on here before. I loved all the different answers that we got and that were submitted, but the winner for this year is Big Mouth.
Yes, I was new glad to the for this one.
They are new to the Sassies there on that one.
I actually love this show. It's real, really, really dirty and funny and sort of poignant at times, relatable, but has fantastic voice acting, and there's music in it. I don't know. It's fucking great. I love that show so much. I'm glad it won.
Good. Wait, is it one that you would have, like, if you would put in your nomination, would you have put it in?
Yeah.
Do you know what I would have given my nomination to? Carmen Sandiego.
Well, yeah, that was really good, too. But
Yep.
What were some of the other that got nominated?
Rick and Morty, which didn't, I've also never watched much Rick and Morty, but that one did not surprise me.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go down, hang on right quickly. I don't know why I'm like scrolling, because I actually have a tabulations page where I Jen Miranda, sorry, medicated and itchy were not two of the words that you used to describe me, but that's what I'm going to use to describe current state. So we got Rick and Morty, Voltron Legendary Defender, which it is a good show,
mm-hmm.
Big Mouth, Venture Brothers, which I am not familiar with, and I apologize.
Venture Brothers?
I'm not familiar with that one.
I know what that is, but I didn't think they had any episodes in 2018. But I could be wrong.
Well, I did say that it was that I'd prefer, you know, when somebody asked me, is it for this year or all time? And I did say treat it as if like any other, treat it like any other award show would, where it's like the previous year or like right before the award show. But because I wasn't familiar with the show, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna allow it. Because
we make our own rules here.
Right? I was like, well, okay. Teen Titans Go, which, woohoo! I love that show.
I know who did not vote for that show.
Well, there's only one vote. I love you, one person. You know who you are. Young Justice Outsiders. Oh, and then, yeah, of course, our Big Mouth nominations.
Sweet.
Not bad at all.
All right, what's next?
Favorite TV comedy!
TV comedy. Okay, that's mine, isn't it?
That is yours.
There's so many that I would have picked here, but...
Me too!
The winner is Brooklyn Nine-Nine, which I'm not mad at. That's a good pick. I like it.
I've only watched parts of this show, so I wasn't entirely mad at it, because I do know it to be a very funny show that has a lot of followers. But some of the other nominations, I was like, dang. Our beloved Atypical was nominated.
Oh, good.
Yeah. And then Superstore, which you and I both also love.
I do love that show.
So, yeah. I wasn't mad, but I was like, it's not who I would have nominated, only because, like, I don't watch it, so. I would have gone with The Good Place, because I'm still totally digging it.
Mm-hmm. All right, what's next?
So this one, I was a little shocked, but I'll take it. Because, you know, this is my favorite category. Favorite, yeah, it's got Miranda written all over it. Favorite TV crime drama, and our winner is True Detective.
See, now this is great. I'm actually kind of in the middle of watching the third season of True Detective, and it's fucking great.
Popular to contrary belief, Miranda has never seen an episode of True Detective.
Oh my god. The first season is legendary. Like, just...
Well, see, okay. I think I saw a few episodes of season one. Because who was in season one? Like, season it's not the same people that are in it now.
No, it was Matthew McConaughey.
Yes, and, I have seen season one then.
Yeah, and, oh god, the other guy. Anyway, he was great too.
Okay, so that's why I thought I hadn't seen it, because I knew who was currently in it, and I was like, no.
Yeah, it's sort of like an anthology. Each season kind of stands on its own.
You know, okay, you know, so kind of like, American Horror Story kind of deal. Each season is its
own. Yeah, kind of like that.
Gotcha. Okay.
Woody Harrelson was the other guy in that one.
Yes, Woody Harrelson. The Criminal Minds was nominated. Shout out T Fabulous, fabulous person there.
Is that the one you would have went with?
Oh, really?
I'm just saying, you have a lot.
I do have a lot. But yeah, it would have, there's some things going on in a couple of my NCASs that I'm not sure what they're fixing to do, and I think I know what they're fixing to do, and it's going to upset me severely.
Oh, no.
So yeah, it would have been Criminal Minds for this year.
Okay.
This is another Jenny tiebreaker here.
Yeah. This one is favorite competition TV show. And I think that American Ninja Warrior is a pretty good winner there.
I would agree.
I think they have like a new, of course I don't know if it would have counted for these awards, but doesn't The Rock have a new like competition show?
Somebody actually did nominate it.
Oh, really?
The Rock's Titan Games. Haven't watched it yet, though.
No,
so
I
don't
either.
Know. I've heard it's really good, actually.
When did that start?
January, February.
Okay. Well,
so like just on the borderline that it technically it can be nominated.
We're real loose with these rules.
I am. Like,
you know, maybe we should next year we should come up with the nominees and then just make them pick from our choices.
Well, you know, that's what the Academy kind of does, is they nominate, and then someone else votes.
Like, maybe that would, like, do it, like...
Can you imagine us sitting down at a piece, at a table, and, like, trying to pick, like, four or five for each of these genres?
Oh, we could do that. We could do that.
No, I think we could, but do you know how many hours and how much alcohol would be involved?
Well, I mean, hey, all the more reason. Don't threaten me with a good time. Come on, now. That sounds like something would be right up our alley, you and me. We would have fun doing that. And then we could make it like the candy tournament and like do the polls on the Facebook page.
I'm really digging the candy tournament.
Yeah, it's really cool, right?
Although sometimes I see people like, I'm like, I vote, and so the way it works is PlayStation, there's a candy tournament right now. And it's on Facebook, and you vote, and there's two things put up there, and you get to vote, like, one against the other.
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't tell you the percentage of what's winning until you vote. Take your vote, right? And so, like, I'll click on my pick, and I'll be like, you savages, how could you think that is better? Well, like, the Andy's Mint one, I was like, how could you people?
Why? Like... Against?
Why would you not vote for anything?
Okay, but it was against Peanut M&Ms, right?
The
second round. I think the second round it
round,
was.
Yes, like the first round, I was like...
Yeah, well, it won that pretty easy, though.
It did eventually, but at first I was like, what is going... can't handle this right now.
I do love Andy's Mints, but I picked Peanut M&Ms.
Oh, this round, I was like, oh, God. They're both... I love them both. Like...
Wait till we get to some of the later matchups.
I know.
My number one pick out of all these... my heart says Snickers, but my head says peanut butter cups. So, those are my two picks.
Which peanut butter cups?
Like, just regular Reese's peanut butter cups.
No, I will object that the best ones are the ones that come out at different seasons that have no edges.
Oh, yeah, the eggs and the pumpkins.
Eggs, pumpkins, trees.
Well, I think that's basically what it is, though. They have basketballs now?
They got basketballs!
Huh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, I found them randomly somewhere. I was like, yes, thank you, I think I will.
But, I mean, that's basically the same thing, though.
Yeah, pretty much. Like, when you, let's be real. When you open the package, doesn't matter if it's an egg or a tree or a basketball, it's all pretty much the same shape.
Yeah.
Like,
if you've had it in your purse for a couple days, like I usually do, it's like half melted and smushed, but you still eat it anyway.
There's new ones for me to vote on. What?
You gonna do some live voting right now?
Ooh, I could live vote. What's so, vote? Airheads or Lifesavers? Miranda says Lifesavers.
Lifesavers, yeah. I don't remember which one I voted for.
And you're currently winning. Blow Pops or Lifesaver Mint Green, Winto Mint Green. Winto Green, dear God, I can't say it right.
Winto Mint.
Winto Mint. Lifesavers Mint Winto Green. Winto Green. Jesus Christ. Something is... Never mind.
Sorry, you got me on that one.
So, for nostalgia reasons, I'm going with the Winto Greens.
All right. Why is that nostalgic?
We used to get them from the little ladies at church.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Like, when we wanted candy, mm-hmm. she'd give us the Winto Green or a Werther's. And look, next, Brock's Lemon Drops or Werther's Originals. Werther's
on that
straight
one.
Up.
Yep.
I will buy them to this day.
The ladies in my church would always, like, rattle the little wrapper for, like, 18 minutes trying to get the fucking mint out.
Mm-hmm. And then the last one is Jolly Ranchers or Charms, and I'm definitely going
to vote. Oh, I don't think I voted on these either, so I will also live vote.
Yeah. See, one of my very favorite candy bars has always been the Musketeer, so I'm like real confused about how I'm gonna continue this.
It just, it brings up a lot of moral dilemmas when you try to compare your candies.
Right? Well, and then on, some days you might want a Kit Kat, and on other days you want a Mars bar, and then some days you want a peanut butter Twix.
Well, in the Raisinets versus Reese's Pieces, that's really not even a matchup at all, so...
That is no contest. That is Reese's Pieces every day.
Yes. Now, Tootsie Roll and Milk Duds, that's a good one.
Tootsie Roll, no question.
I agree, because Milk Duds are bleh.
Well, they get stuck in your teeth.
Yeah, they're all gross. Turtles and Whoppers.
Turtles.
I like Whoppers, but I can only eat four. And then... plain M&M's versus crispy M&M's.
Plain. No questions. I think I had the crispy ones once and was like, no thanks.
Who's voting for Rolos?
I think I did, actually.
Uh-uh.
What was it against?
Peanut M&M's.
Oh, no. Peanut M&M's straight up.
I thought the Andes went up against peanut M&M's, but it went up against Hershey Kisses.
Yep.
I voted for Hershey Kisses.
That's what it was. Yeah. Where I was like, you fools.
Yeah.
You really picking the Kisses over the
Andes? That's another hard one, though. Pretty close in voting, too.
Now, if you had given me Kisses, Hugs, and Andes Mints... That would have been a hard decision there.
Why is that different?
Because remember, it's double layer kind of deal. It's like a white chocolate, a milk chocolate wrapped, and then the white chocolate on the outside.
Does the white chocolate put it over the top for you?
It does, because white chocolate's my favorite.
Have you had white chocolate M&Ms?
I have. I was just really? I was like, I'm kind of sad.
I thought they were pretty good.
They're good, but I don't know. I guess because I got all excited and I was like, "What?" I'm like, "Yeah!" And then they were just no,
just kind of meh.
Yeah, I was like,
meh. Well, whatever. All right. I we went on this candy tangent. The Sassy Award for Best Candy Tournament goes to Place to Be Nation.
Yeah, I like how you said that with such enthusiasm.
I'm just saying, it does.
You're like, it goes to Place to Be Nation.
Because we're the best, and we came up with it. All right. We're about halfway through the Sassies. What do you think, Miranda, so far? Yeah? All right, well, let's take a break, and then we will be back to give away the rest of the awards.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Place to Be Nation's JT Rosero and Chad Campbell here. We want to let you know that we have over 24 podcasts available on iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, and PlaceToBeNation.com. We now offer them to you on two great feeds. On the Place to Be Nation Wrestling feed, we dive into topics running the gamut from today's WWE to the glory days of yesteryear and the ins and outs of the territory days. In addition to our full-length shows, we also deliver to you special pod blasts on topics old and new.
The Place to Be Nation Pop Feed is a veritable treasure trove of great content, offering tremendous shows covering the land of movies, television, life, comics, and sports, brought to you by the most knowledgeable and insightful folks in the podcast world.
You can find all these great shows, plus archives of our past podcasts from over the past 8 years, as well by subscribing to both feeds on iTunes. And while you're there, be sure to rate and leave feedback as well. All these shows, plus others, available on PlaceToBeNation.com, where we cover pro wrestling, sports, movies, comics, plus in-depth stretch projects, and much more. Be sure to support our site by using www.PlaceToBeNation.com/Amazon when doing your online shopping. We want to thank our friends at Boneheads Wing Bar, ProWrestlingOnly.com, and TheHistoryOfWrestling.com as well. Be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Tumblr. PlaceToBeNation.com, the only place to be in your pop culture world.
Welcome back to Geek and Sassy. Miranda here.
Hi.
Jenny and I have talked a lot about how we are part of Place to Be Nation. We love to remind you guys because we're very proud of the feed that we're on here, which we're on the pop feed. And there's been kind of a very busy week going along our pop feed here. And just to kind of give you a little bit about everybody else so you can listen to them because it's totally worth listening. I'll start with Jenny's other famous show, Freak Out Drive-In. Jenny this week is joined by Andy. Well, and what did you guys talk about, Jenny?
We watched Dawn of the Dead.
Which is a live watch, correct?
Mm-hmm. It was really fun. A zombie movie. Fast zombies.
Dawn of the Dead's a pretty awesome movie. Okay, I'll give you that one. And then Russell and Sam are back with a new 90s to nothing. And this time they are dissecting the classic Thelma and Louise. I have not listened to that yet, but plan to. Mm-hmm. And Andy, again, is welcomed this time by Jennifer and, of course, Scott on this quarter's Looking Forward and Looking Back. These are done quarterly, as it says. And this time they dove into films that were released in the back end of 2018. What are some of the films that you kind of mentioned there, Jen?
The most important one that we talked about, of course, was Spawn. What the fuck? Venom. Spawn just came to my brain like a fucking idiot. Okay. It was Venom. And then, of course, we talked about Bohemian Rhapsody, which Scott and I disagreed about. And, all kinds of goodies. Cool. Including Spawn, for some reason. Fucking moron.
And then, of course, it sounds like Jenny also joined Russell in a new installment of DC Post-Crisis Management and talked Flashpoint.
Yes.
Which I know Jenny loves some Flashpoint.
I do love some Flashpoint. There's some Stephanie McMahon-level bad acting in that episode from both me and Russell, so it's really fun.
And, of course, we have Steve and Kelly in the house with a new Songs with Friends, and they broke down Just My Imagination and Hard to Concentrate. And, of course, rounding out everyone here, do not forget the lovely, amazing Todd, and was joined by Jordan Duncan to look at Netflix Abducted in Plain Sight on the newest Binge Please, which if you have not watched that show, it's crazy, just crazy. Go listen to them and then watch the show. And it sounds like there's a new contest being held over on Looking Forward and Looking Back. And this summer, we are going to be doing a movie wager based on how well you think you can predict how this summer movies releases will be doing domestically in the box office. So what's going to happen is there's going to be 10 movies, or there's going to be 10 movies picked in order of how you think they will finish domestically. And then you will need to include 3 wild card picks as well. And we're going to figure out who the winner is and who the biggest bomb of the summer is. And Jenny and I are both going to be part of that version of Looking Forward, Looking Back.
Yep.
So, if you would like to participate in that, please do so by sending your picks over to Jenny. Please read this because my eyeballs will not let me.
It's sort of like a shortened version. It's... I almost said it like phonetically the way that it's spelled just to be a smartass, but then I thought I would probably just say spawn instead, so spawn at gmail.com. No, send it to LFLB pop. So looking forward, looking back, but just LFLB pop at gmail.com.
By Monday, April 22nd.
Yes.
Eyeball could not read that. Like, I don't know why. Anyway, so this is for any movie that is released on or after April 26th, and the tallying will end Labor Day, September 2nd, and the winner of the contest gets to be in a future episode of Love in Theater, which is a fantastic new show with Andy Atherton. Mm-hmm. And if you're listening to the opening of that show, you might recognize someone there.
I know, that was a nice little treat to hear. I was surprised by it and delighted.
Aww.
All right, so over on the PTV and Wrestling feed and the newest Place to Be podcast, JT Scott and Peter Winston take a look at the March 1989 Saturday night's main event, and Peter Winston sings a song that is hilarious, so you need to listen to that. Nick and Greg delivered What If? Number 2 as they examine a world in which CM Punk doesn't leave WWE in 2014.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. And we continue our dip into the Where the Big Boys Play Vault as Chad and Parv start to look at Starrcade 87. Starrcades are my favorite WCW podcast. I mean, fucking goddamn interviews. What the fuck is wrong with me? All right.
The best live read ever.
I'm fucking sober, too. That's ridiculous. All right. And be sure to check out PlaceToBeNation.com as things are getting back up and running there with plenty of projects and reviews to come. Content will be picking back up in the days and weeks ahead. And, of course, we've already talked quite a bit about the PTBN Greatest Candy Tournament. So just search for PTBN Greatest Candy Tournament in Facebook, and it'll take you to the page. And you can vote daily. And then the winner is crowned on Easter.
You can vote on Twitter, too. There's the poll. And Twitter, the polls are also on Twitter if you're a Twitter person.
So, wow. If I can speak, we could maybe finish giving out these awards. You know what? I edit our show now, so it could be that I just edit all that out. You know, all my fuck-ups.
Let's not. I think that's why people love us, though.
Because I say dumb shit? Yeah.
Well, no, because we're us. Like, we're just us, and we don't heavily edit who we are out of.
Well, I would like to edit things to make me sound like a fucking moron, but that would be, like,
well, 90% you didn't sound like
of what I do.
You didn't sound like a moron. Like, your brain was like, Spawn!
I don't know why. Why? what the hell? I'm not doing any more sober podcasts, okay? Because, I don't know. It's just not, like, it puts me off my game now. I don't.
Okay.
Just saying. All right, what's next on this here?
We should be at favorite sci-fi fantasy show.
Is that you or me?
I think it's me.
Okay, do that.
All right. So, our winner, which this one was super close. Like, I almost had to be like, Jenny!
I would not have picked this, so that's great.
Well, and you probably would have picked from one of the others that I was almost thinking for just a second. You were going to have to break it for me. But our winner, before I give you some of the nominees, goes to Game of Thrones.
That's a very popular show.
It is. It is. And honestly, there were some that I was surprised were not even nominated. But a few others that made it that were very, very close. I'll be honest with you. It was almost a three-way tie between Game of Thrones, Happy, and DC's Legends of Tomorrow.
Oh, Legends would have won that.
Yeah, if I had texted Jenny, like, I knew without doubt, if I had texted Jenny and been like, break it, what she would have said. Sure. But we ended up getting another ballot that broke it.
Gotcha.
So, to Game of Thrones it goes, which is also a winner that it's their show will be ending.
Yeah, that's true.
Their new season will be airing just shortly.
Yeah.
What is it, like 40 days?
Yeah.
Maybe less than?
People are going to be losing their minds.
Yeah.
Now, were there any unusual nominations for sci-fi fantasy show?
You're going to make me do it, aren't you?
I am.
So, it made me giggle, and it made me giggle because I haven't seen this show, so I was like, did not know that constituted as a sci-fi fantasy, but alrighty. Let me get my nominees pulled back up here because my computer wanted to be a butthead. But just to give you the others that were on here, we had Krypton,
mm-hmm.
Not unusual.
Krypton.
Stranger Things, mm-hmm. Not unusual. Black Lightning,
mm-hmm.
Again, not unusual.
Well, kind of, but okay.
Well, sci-fi.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. But Smilf was nominated.
Smilf, which, right.
Smilf. It made me laugh a little. I'm sorry. I wasn't aware that it was sci-fi or fantasy. Although, Jenny did inform me that there were some parts during season one that apparently were fantasy-esque.
There were parts that were weird, just like kind of off the wall. But I would, for me, I think that show is more comedic or like family drama, kind of, or dark comedy than sci-fi. But, you know, maybe it was more the fantasy that was, because she does, I mean, she's weird, but anyway, I don't know. Game of Thrones is a solid win.
Congratulations to Game of Thrones on your
I'm sure they won't win any more awards ever for anything.
I see that Game of Thrones cash cow being milked for a long time. Long time.
All right, next we got favorite movie, which, I mean, that's a difficult
category. If you
want to
go ahead, and, honestly, if you want to go ahead and do the next two together,
okay,
you can, because this one wins two Sassies.
Two Sassies, Tim two. Capel. Tim Capel, Avengers Infinity War, wins two Sassy Awards for favorite movie and favorite comic book movie.
Why are we calling out Tim on this one?
Because he hates Infinity War. And he really, really loves it when people bring it up that he hates Infinity War.
I had honestly forgotten that he hated Infinity War, but now I remember, and it won two, Tim, two. In the same year. Two
Sassies. Did she just turn into Count Dracula?
I did. Sure as hell did. There were some notable...
We're some nonsense people tonight, I'll tell you that.
That's all right. I will say there were some notable nominations in both categories. Mm-hmm. A lot of them bleeding over into both categories. Mm-hmm. Black Panther was listed in both. Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, honestly, was almost our winner for favorite comic book movie.
Mm-hmm.
But Infinity War got one more vote than Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse did.
I did love Into the Spider-Verse, but...
Oh, I love Spider-Verse.
I would probably pick Infinity War over it, though.
I don't know. I love them both equally for different reasons. Yeah. So I don't know. And then on the favorite movie front, we had some other great ones. Incredibles 2, A Quiet Place, Bohemian Rhapsody, again, Black Panther, Mission Impossible Fallout, and A Star is Born.
Nice.
So, notables in both of those.
Oh, did Greg pick Fallout?
I want to say that he did.
Okay.
I would have to look at the actual, like, five-person nominations. But
you mean
I
you didn't memorize that for me?
Well, some of them I did because they stood out. But I'm pretty sure that one... did belong to... Actually, no. It does not belong to Greg.
No?
No, it does not.
Alright.
Does not belong to Gregory. Now, should we take a guess of...
Yeah, now I'm like, keep trying to figure out who voted for what.
If you get it right, you get the candy that you voted for.
Oh, okay. I get some Airheads.
Did you seriously vote for Airheads?
Yeah, I did.
What is wrong with you? God.
So many things.
Oh. Stick to your teeth. It's the reason we didn't vote for Rolos.
I'm trying to think of everybody that submitted ballots who would have voted for Fallout.
One bag of Airheads, your answer is...
Garner. Damn it.
The answer would be David Sunday.
Oh,
Sunday Groove. Well,
I was close enough.
So because it's from our friends pool,
yes.
Is what you're saying?
I'm just saying, I deserve credit for that.
You get one airhead.
Okay.
You don't get a bag of them anymore, but you get one airhead.
Okay.
Or no, what is it? When you go to the Mexican restaurant, you can buy 3 for $1. I'll give you 3. Oh, dear God.
I love All right. tacos and airheads.
Oh, Lord. Anyway, our next category is favorite TV actress. And our winner, very well deserved, to Miss Emily Bett Rickards of Arrow.
Oh, Felicity herself, who is
Yay.
Not going to be in the final season of Arrow.
No.
Which is surprising. And
which I do anticipate there to be more announcements of more people that will not be in the final season.
What?
Well.
Really?
With it being 10 episodes long, I truly anticipate there being more to come that will not be part of that.
Huh. Well, I don't know how they're going to do that in the story, then.
If I end up being right, I get a whole box of Andy's mints.
All right.
Just saying.
Who else?
I bet Andy loves how we are, like, turning this candy tournament into part of our,
I'm sure he's delighted. Or he should be.
He should be. He better be, because he loves us both.
Mm-hmm. Who else got nominated?
Some other actually really great nominations. Danielle Panabaker, Regina King, Wendy McClendon McCovey, which I am not familiar with, or at least if I am, I'm not the name. I might be the face.
Mm. That is a mouthful of a name there.
That is a mouthful of a name. Kristen Ritter, Kiernan Shipka, and Ellie Kemper. Mm. So some other really great ones.
Mm-hmm. Try to, I think that Mrs. Maisel, Rachel Brosnahan. Hey, I said a word right.
You did!
I think she should be in the running for that as well.
So that would have been okay. I do know who Wendy McClendon Covey. If you look her up, you will know her face.
Okay,
she is the mom in the Goldbergs and has been on
a ton
of other stuff.
Yeah.
Just didn't realize that was the lady's name.
Right.
I'm not sure who I would have nominated for that one. To be honest with you, not sure.
So we got favorite TV actor, and the winner, Grant Gustin, The Flash. That's kind of surprising for me, too.
It was almost a tie between him and a male. Which we had some really good nominations on that one, too.
What were those?
So we had Dan Levy, of course, Stephen Amell. We had John Bernthal, Norman Reedus, of course, Grant Gustin, our winner, Kristen Maloney, and Penn Badgley.
Ooh, Penn was pretty great.
He was. Honestly, I might have picked him. Just because, that show was just, dear God.
John Bernthal is great, though.
And John Bernthal is amazing. Yes. Yes. So then, moving on to favorite movie actor, our winner here this year is Michael B. Jordan.
That's a good pick.
It is a good pick.
Mm-hmm. Between Black Panther and Creed, Creed 2,
right?
Which I haven't seen yet, but I hear is really good.
No, I haven't seen that one either, but both had great box office numbers, and apparently he was fantastic in both of them, and he's been good in other things, that I've seen him in before, so no disappointment in that winner there. Again, we had strong, for actor and actresses in both TV and movie, we had really great nominees.
Who else is for actor?
So we had Rami Malek, Idris Elba, Bill Hader, Jason Momoa, Dwayne "The Rock" Johnson, Jenny's favorite person.
Jesus fuck, who voted for him?
If I tell you, you'll be mean to them.
Is this, like, supposed to deter me from wanting to know?
I will look, and I will tell you.
All right.
I do genuinely like
that. I feel like that was a trolling vote.
It was not a trolling vote.
Kind of feel like it was.
They didn't know that you wouldn't be tabulating. So how is it trolling?
They know Andy, I would find out.
Andy, just remember you're still my best friend.
It was not Andy.
I didn't say it was. I just said Andy was still my best friend.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Other nominees were also my Bradley Cooper and Chris Hemsworth. Mm. And James McAvoy. James McAvoy. Mm. So, a lot of really good options mm-hmm. there.
Mm-hmm. Well, for favorite movie actress, we got The Sassy Goes to Lady Gaga.
No surprise. Mm. Get hashtag Place to Be Nation's new hashtag, give it to Gaga. Yep.
That would have been your vote?
That. Possibly.
Yeah.
Possibly. She won, hands down. Like, there was no needing to.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, there was no needing to. We did have some other great options, but there was no needing to ask for a break on this one.
Okay.
And another hands-down winner, which I am kind of surprised with, not mad at, but our favorite soundtrack goes to Captain Marvel.
Which is funny because it came out this year.
It did, but it came out at the beginning, so technically it does count.
What does that mean? It came out in March.
I know, but like...
That's not the beginning.
Award shows always, like, if it bleeds over into, like, those first few months there, they'll sometimes, like, go ahead and let them have it. I ain't mad at it, and I ain't fighting it, because Captain Marvel came out on my birthday, and it rocked my socks off, so...
Yeah, I'm not arguing that, I'm just saying, like, our rules are shaky.
One, two, three, four votes, it went to Captain Marvel.
Alright. I'll let you have it, Carol.
Thank you.
So our favorite musical album. I'm interested to see the other nominees on this one as well. But the winner would be Cardi B for
this made
Cardi Invasion of Privacy.
This made Carol's face do funny things.
Mm-hmm. I like Cardi though.
She's all right. I mean, not really my genre, mm-hmm. but she's all right. I mean.
I'm kind of addicted to that song, Money, right now, so I might play that at the end of this.
So other nominations were Kamikaze by Eminem.
No, that's good.
That is good.
I enjoyed it.
It is good. Like, I do like that one. The Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse soundtrack, which is good.
See, why would that not be a soundtrack? Nominee.
I don't know, but it technically that was their favorite musical album too. So.
Oh, both. Okay, yeah. That would have won.
Like,
for
it was
me.
A nomination for their favorite musical album.
That would have won for me for soundtrack for sure. And yeah, go ahead.
No, I could see that. It's a good nomination. Mm-hmm. The Bohemian Rhapsody soundtrack was also nominated as favorite musical album.
Hmm.
And all you people in your Cardi B.
How many votes did Cardi get?
Cardi got 3.
Oh, nice.
So I guess Miss Jessica Cruz over there can have her Cardi B, and Carol Danvers is just going to sit here with a funny look on her face. I'm just saying.
All right, here's a decidedly sassy award.
Yes.
Exclusive.
It's not sassy if you don't got this.
Exclusive to the Sassies. And that is favorite ship. And favorite ship goes to Alicity from Arrow, which is good. Although, they're married now, so I don't know how much you want to ship them.
Everyone still wants them together, I think, is their point. Because there was another married couple on the list.
Who else?
The West Allen pairing.
Mm. Yep. Yeah, I just feel like once you're married, you kind of move off my ship radar. You know what I mean?
Yeah, we have not. You know, maybe next installment of Geek and Sassy.
Mm.
We need to do Ship It, because we haven't done Ship It in a while.
No, we haven't, because we haven't done Geek and Sassy in a
while. No, I mean, well, even when we haven't done Ship It in a while.
Uh-huh. Got lots of options.
We do. I do want to give a shout out to the person that nominated Ray Palmer and Nora Dark.
Oh,
you have my heart.
One. Yeah, that's
you
good.
Have my heart. That would have been my ship.
Hmm.
Yeah, that would have been mine for sure.
I'm trying to think of what mine would be. I don't know. So many.
Like, I definitely need Ray. And Nora, like, I need that to happen.
Mm-hmm. I think it probably will.
CW has a bad will-they-won't-they problem, though. So I'd, like, just need it to happen.
Not in a while, though, it feels like.
No, but I'm afraid because it hasn't been in a while that you're about to do it.
Mm.
just cut that out. Just
I don't know.
Put Ray and Nora together. Thank you.
All right, are we down to the final award?
We are down to the most important and final award of the second annual Geek and Sassy's Sassy Awards.
All right.
And that is our very highly sometimes questionable, but always favorite part of the show, favorite nerd eye candy of the moment. Then who's our winner, Jenny?
In a surprise win, Scarlett Johansson.
I will say I was just a little surprised, too.
Yeah, I mean, like, that seems like an old school pick. I mean, not calling her old, but I'm just saying, like, not many people, like, fawn over her too much anymore. I don't know.
Yeah.
Or maybe she's just, like, an old favorite, you know?
I think that's honestly what it is that she's just an old favorite.
Not calling her old. I'm just saying.
No, like.
She's been hot for, like, a real long time.
Right.
So.
No, I agree with you there.
Yeah.
More of, like, she's not. Well, I mean, I guess because Infinity War, technically, she had a movie last year, so. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't know.
Some others. Danielle Panabaker. Penn Badgley. Candace Patton. Aubrey Plaza. Michael B. Jordan.
Hmm.
Yep. Hmm. So those were some of the others.
Hmm.
Oh, and I guess I have to mention the one or we'll get in trouble. Somebody put Alexa Bliss.
I don't know. All right.
But we have a Nerd Eye Candy this time.
We do. Oh, I think we're going to, kind of give out our first, do you want to call it like an honorary award?
Honorary lifetime achievement.
Lifetime achievement.
Lifetime achievement. This person has been on our hot radar for a hot second.
Mm-hmm.
Very long time. Yeah. Yeah, it's been a long time. Most likely, possibly, some of our listeners, maybe original Heartthrob?
Gotta be on the list of originals.
Right, yeah. On the list of at least.
For sure. And then sadly.
Sadly, yes.
Yeah, he's no longer with us anymore, but we're going to give the Lifetime Achievement Nerd Eye Carry, God damn it, Candy. To Luke Perry.
Yes. To the wonderful, amazing Luke Perry. This is our first ever Lifetime Nerd Eye Candy Award. And sadly, gone too soon, honestly, in my opinion.
And, you know, he was young, you know, and just so sudden, and I feel awful for, you know, everybody that knew him and loved him. All you heard was like great things about him and how wonderful he was and kind and funny. Yeah. And, you know, you never heard any horror stories about him, no. Which is, I'm not going to say rare, but it's sort of refreshing.
In this day, it is very refreshing, right? Because I think too often we hear nothing but the horror stories of people in Hollywood and people well thought of, mm-hmm. honestly.
And, you know, stayed hot till the end.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. For sure.
Ah, now I'm sad.
I am too. Dang it. You know what can make you happy?
What?
The smell of this candle.
What does it smell like?
In other news, trying to make us not so sad anymore. So, it's been really big in Romancelandia, and I don't know why, because this guy doesn't have anything to do with romance books. He actually has a lot to do with the comic book world. But apparently, a couple of weeks ago, a new Yankee Candle came out from the Yankee Candle Company called Mountain Lodge. No, this is not a solicitation for the Yankee Candle Company, because I very much had to pay the $27.99 for this candle. Now, should they want to reimburse me or send me lots more of these, we might discuss that. But no, at this time, Miranda paid her own $27.99 for this Mountain Lodge 14.5-ounce candle.
You a candle, so, Mark.
Yeah. It's one of the actual, like, jar.
Yeah.
Like, the smaller jar. Anyway.
The one where I pick it up and smell it, it's like, this is really good, but I'm not paying $30 for this fucking candle.
Well, I'll tell you why I did. Okay? So, a couple weeks ago, Yankee Candle came out with this new candle, and somehow, and I'd have to go back and dig and find out how this came to be, somehow, like I said, it's called Mountain Lodge, but it is now being sold out everywhere. From, like, the votives to the tall candles, it's super hard to find because it has been deemed the Chris Evans candle. Because apparently this is what he actually smells like.
According to
people that know him, like, personally, and that, like, people have met him.
Mm-hmm.
Like, not personally, but, like, people have met him and then people that know him personally. So, all the girls in my book group that I'm part of, from the wonderful ladies over at Heaving Bosoms, they have a group on Facebook called the Heaving Bosoms Geriatric Friendship Club. Best name ever. So, the girls in there, as they were getting their candle, were doing videos of their, like, thoughts, right? And they were all really, really cute. So I got mine in the mail, and I was like, you know what? Sure, I'm going to make my own video, too. Which I might share with you guys, but the reason I didn't is because you had no context, and you were going to be like, what the fuck is this talking about?
You should have done it.
I still may launch it before this airs, yeah. And then they'll be like, oh... So it's a real quick video, but the candle came and I did not smell it. And then when I got done with my work day the other day, I propped my camera up and I was like pulling, I have it in my hand, I'm showing it off because I'm all excited, right? And then I go to sniff it because I'm like, I don't know if this smells like Chris Evans or any Chris. Because somebody made the comment in the group, it's not fair, it's called Mountain Lodge. Like, I think of Chris Pine, and I'm like, right, his name is Pine? How's that fair? Whatever. Okay. And then somebody showed the gif of Chris Evans chopping wood, and I was like, there you go. Uh-huh. Which, didn't I share? I shared on Facebook the clip of Chris Evans kind of, like, gurring and talking about how he wanted to be a daddy.
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, oh, I'm there for that.
So, has Chris Evans, like, acknowledged this candle thing? Is this, like, a common knowledge type?
Like, I haven't seen him acknowledge it yet, but I'm waiting to find out if he's going to acknowledge it. Because at this point, it's now being, like, hashtag Chris Evans candle. Like, it's everywhere.
Oh, is it?
Oh, yeah. Well, in Romance Land, Twitter world. Okay. It is. So, and seriously, like, the places are selling out. Like, I was really amazed. So I got one, and I waited until I made this recording to sniff it. And I smell it, and you can audibly hear me smelling it. And the video is truly genuine. But I have decided, I don't know if this smells like Chris Evans, but it smells like Jerry, and I am here for it.
Aww.
I am all up in this candle. Like, I just keep... Oh, my God. It smells really good.
Okay, so they market it as... smelling like the perfect lumberjack boyfriend. Which... All right.
Well, I am here for it. And if I could buy more of them, every friend... may get this for their birthday or holiday for, like, the rest of the year. Unless I just don't want to give it up.
This is so funny. Like, people are, like, posting pictures of it with Captain America figures.
I'm telling you, dude. Like, comic book world and Romance Landia cross way more than you people
That's
think.
That's funny.
Make fun of me. Call me my snut novels. I am still smelling this candle. Like, for real, y'all.
Well, oh, crap. Now I want one.
Oh, my God. It is the best shit ever. And everybody keeps making fun of me. And they're like, Miranda, you need to burn it. And I'm like, no, then it goes away.
That's true.
Then it's gone. And I also have this fear. I also have this fear that, have you ever bought a candle that it smells like amazing and then you burn it and you're like, what the hell is that?
Maybe one time, yeah, I did.
I've had it happen a handful of times. So I have a fear that if I burn it, then I'll hate it. And then again, if I burn it, it goes away.
Well, you could just do it in little pieces, you know. They have it on Amazon Prime, apparently.
That's where I got it.
Okay.
I wanted it now.
Yeah. I can't spend $27.50 on a candle. I just can't do it.
You gave me a gift card for my birthday.
Mm-hmm.
So it may have only cost me like $4.
Well, that works. So technically, I did pay $27. So
technically, you did pay $25 for a Mountain
Lion. God damn it.
But if you knew how much happiness.
Well, I am glad that it's bringing you happiness.
Like, seriously. Can you guys. If I could give you smell-a-cast. Not smell-a-vision, because, you know. If I could give you smell-a-cast. I'd totally give you this.
Smelly cast.
But then I'd quickly take it from you because I don't want to let all the vapors out, you know. You can't have this. This is mine. This is mine.
Oh, my gosh.
I hate this.
All right. So, that is it for the Sassies. Do we want to talk a little bit about sort of what we want to do going forward? As far as the podcast?
Well, sure.
All right. Just because there might be another hiatus after this episode?
Possible hiatus delay. Mm-hmm. We won't know for a couple more weeks. Let's just say somebody somewhere is getting their blessing because apparently Miranda won't be able to talk for a few weeks.
Well,
more like month and a half.
Oh, my gosh. Really that long?
I'm not looking forward to it.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, for 3 months, I'm not allowed to eat anything that I can't cut with a plastic fork and that's not any bigger than the size of, like, a goldfish cracker.
So you're going to get super skinny.
Oh, hell yeah. And that's the one part that I keep telling myself, silver fucking lining.
Well, how are you going to work?
So I've already, like, talked to my boss about this, and I don't actually talk to a lot of people throughout the day anyway.
Oh, okay.
Unless they need help. Mm-hmm. So she's already very aware of it for, like, a 3 month, or at least a month and a half, possible 3 month time period. I would not be able to, call our candidates to get anything taken care of with them over the phone. Like, mm-hmm. I would have to do everything via email. But the day-to-day assignments that I have, and like I said, unless they need help, I don't actually talk to any candidates. So I just wouldn't, the downfall is I wouldn't be able to train anybody during that time should we need someone to be trained.
Okay. Well, that's not too bad.
Yeah, no.
So anyway, hopefully we might could record one more time before
I'm crossing my fingers for twice, but we'll see.
Because it feels like every time we like realign ourselves and get a schedule and get a plan, like we want to do this show, we want to do this show, and we get our shit straight, and then something happens and it derails us from doing those things. So we have lots of ideas. It's just, you know, sort of the real life things that get in the way. But we don't want to not do this, right? Mm-hmm. So
no, definitely this is something I want to continue for as long as possible.
Right. So don't worry if you don't hear from us in a bit, and you know, just keep listening when we do record. That would be very helpful.
Yes.
And of course, like we've said, check out both of our feeds and all the great shows that we mentioned and everything else that's going on there. And then you can find us on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook at Geek and Sassy. And I am on Twitter at JennyCruz2814. Miranda is on Twitter at Mom's a Nerd. And so that wraps up the second annual Sassy Awards.
Yes. Thank you to everyone that sent in ballots and took time out of your busy day and lives to not only to continue to listen to us, but to give us your feedback and send in suggestions and nominees and everything else. It truly, even if I giggle at you, it means a lot to us.
Yes.
And it does mean a lot to the ones of you that really wanted to, but like life gets away, we know, and you weren't able to.
All right. So that's it. Thank you for listening.
And you're welcome for talking. Baby mommy with a clip, walk out bodies with a bitch, bring a thotty to the